Hi everyone, welcome back to my Beach Angel Tarot Shop. I'm here to do my weekly reading for the week of December 13th through 19th. And my weekly readings are always focused on the energy of love, romance, and partnership in whatever form it is coming for you. So we're going to take a look and see what Spirit has for everyone this week. I hope everyone has had a wonderful week last week and moving forward. And we're going to see, I'm going to be using this deck. And this deck is called Wisdom of the House of Night. And this is a very beautiful deck. I don't use it a lot, and there's no particular reason, because it is a beautiful deck. Just don't think to use it, but I was guided to it today. So there's something in here, there's a message. When I see this, it brings up the energy of that, or the lyrics of that song, Witchy Woman, Sparks Fly from Her Fingertips. So it always comes to mind when I see that picture on that box. We're going to get a message to everyone from this deck. I was guided back to my Under the Rose Lenormand, and which is a very beautiful deck, and my Romance Angels. So we're going to see what comes up and how it comes up this week. I have no particular energy coming to me, and that in itself is an energy. It's almost like anything's possible. I'm not getting led in any specific direction right now for whatever the reason. So maybe a bit of mysterious energy around this week, what's going to happen. And just not really getting anything by myself. So we're going to see what comes. It's almost like a blank slate. Maybe that's, well, we are in the new moon, so that can be it, you know, planting those seeds and allowing that intention to come up. So happy new moon too, that just all of a sudden came to me. So I'm a little tired today, so excuse me, but that may be what is coming. So really planning your intentions, staying focused for this week is going to be important, and you will see that what you want to manifest come forward. So using this time, I think I'm going to pull one from here and get an overall energy message for this upcoming week from this deck, and then move into the other deck, two decks for the rest of the message. So we never know how exactly it's going to come. Oh, wow, that's definitely it. And there's two. See, I said, I think I'm going to do one, but Spirit always has another, not always, but sometimes has another plan for us than what we have for ourselves. So that in itself can be another message. First one is reminder. Don't forget. So don't forget something this week. Not forgetting someone or not forgetting a date or an anniversary. For some, this may come up that way. And it's 28. So 28 is one. One is something new. Can't forget something new. And the next one is loyalty. Don't forget loyalty. The energy of loyalty is coming up here as important. Black-Eyed Susan is also coming up very strongly here. And just going to hold it. These cards are beautiful. They're beautiful cards. Loyalty to, don't forget, and to remind. Being reminded, you're being reminded of loyalty this week. To being loyal to someone, or someone's loyalty to you in the past, or how loyal someone has been to you, is going to be important. And this seems like a, kind of gives me the energy like a headstone, too. So it could be somebody from, that has passed over, sending someone a message of the loyalty that they had, thanking them for the loyalty that they've given them in this life. And, you know, I feel like maybe the woman is here in life and the man has passed, or their partner has passed. And they're sending, sort of giving me that energy of the ivy is trailing up, and it's someone that has been passed over, maybe for a while, but definitely sending a message that they don't forget. They haven't forgotten your loyalty. And because of the one, I feel it's a message to someone. They want you to move on. They're still with you, and they haven't forgotten what you've given them, but it's time to move on with the one. It's going to bring more harmony and balance to you, and that it is okay. So that is a message that just came up there. Could be for one particular person that is drawn to the video at some point. And timing could be any time. It could be any time in the future, but that is the message, because I was really getting that feeling from this card, that it was the headstone and someone in spirit giving a message. So interesting message. In general, don't forget about being loyal to the rest of those that are watching for the energy. But I feel it was just a separate message for someone this week. So we're focusing on, and I've been being guided to do a spirit message, and I haven't sat down to do it. I haven't had the time, and I'm really being guided in that direction. So it could be another reason why that came out. I'm actually seeing four here, so I'm going with it. This could be a little bit of a longer video, and I apologize. They're going in two different directions. The two here are going up, and the two here are going down. So I'm seeing like a mirror effect. I'm going to show it to you. I feel it's important here. It's a mirror effect. So we're going to see. I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to move into here, and then I'll give you everything if I see anything else. So we're going to see. This is interesting. We have the fish. So we have King of Diamonds. We have a male energy, that King of Diamonds energy. We see seven, which is very spiritual. So we see a spiritual male energy coming up here. That is solid. They're secure. They offer security moving forward in emotion, because the fish is in the water, in the depths of the water. It can be a little energy that kind of goes back and forth a little bit. You need to decide which way we're going here. It's coming up from this card for the first one. Underneath it, what was kind of upside down is the lady. So these are a couple that mirror each other. So it could be a twin flame relationship. It could be someone that you feel is a deep soulmate connection. But definitely because they mirrored each other, it's coming up that way. And we see the Ace of Swords here. So that she could also be trying to gain clarity on a male that is offering her emotions that have kind of gone this way and gone that way. She's not sure. She feels this person's a solid individual. And is offering her something solid. But there is an energy of the Ace of Swords. So it's looking for clarity. It's finding clarity or obtaining new clarity within the energy. So those are what I'm seeing coming up here. And we're going to see what else is over here mirroring each other. And they were doing the same. We have the cross, which I, as everyone knows, I love this card. Right now, it's starting to bring up the energy of Christmas to Easter time. As important in this relationship, if you're resonating with this energy. So I feel that Christmas to Easter time is coming up. Of course, this is a connection that can't be broken. If you look up the Lenormand cross, you'll see it can be a burden. There could have been burdens in this relationship, as any relationship that causes us to grow spiritually, like the seven. You know that you have to have some energy where it makes you turn to spirit to grow. So I feel that that's happened in this. But it's ultimately something that is destined. It is something that can't be broken, no matter what happens. So if you're not with the person, you're with them spiritually. It's a spiritual connection. So that is never broken. It can't be. And what's mirroring underneath it, it was doing that same underneath, is the garden. And the garden is all about something that's being more open. That is something that is connecting. The garden is all about good energy. And when we combine it with the cross, it gives me a sense of like heaven, of a spiritual garden, you know, like just very much the heavenly energy, like a spiritual garden would be. So it could be a match made in heaven, that type of energy. It's the number two. The garden is 20, so it's two. It's a partnership, but it's good energy. The garden is somewhere where we enjoy going. We meet with people there, so there could be a destined meeting coming up from this woman with this man that brings more solidity to the relationship. But definitely seeing interesting energy in this message for some. And it can also be tying into this person's message as well. You know, a man from spirit. It could be somebody that was very supportive of this woman. Because we're definitely seeing the woman, and I felt the woman and man energy here, or their partner. But it's somebody that definitely supported you. Somebody that had your back. It could be indicating they are in heaven. They are very comfortable where they're at here with this message. I feel that it's kind of tying in with that as well. Not to say that the other first message I saw wasn't there, but Spirit uses the cards in many ways to get out the message, so I'm definitely feeling that. So we're going to go to the romance angels. We're going to move on, because we can continue to get many messages up off there, but I don't have the time on the video to do that. So I'm going to continue moving forward. And the lattice is sort of showing me the lattice, something that this trailing up the lattice is important, like this trailing up the stone. So again, it's something that has withstood a long time. The partnership is supportive and has grown, or had time to grow because they're showing me that lattice supporting that ivy, just like the stone was supporting that. So something's very supportive. Yeah, that energy of support here is really coming through. So we're going to get... We're going to get the romance angel messages. So I see four here too. Nope, five. It's going a lot longer than I thought here, so I apologize. So there's five over here, and we're going to run through them and see what comes up. So when I was shuffling, the 28 and the 33, the 28 comes to 10, which is 1, 33 to 6. So together, this is spiritual. So this is, again, a spiritual connection, spirit number coming up. So we're going to go see really fast what these are. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. So romantic feelings coming up here. And the energy of exploration is what struck me looking at that. And here we have make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. So exploration and effort is coming up here is important for this week. And wow, that one flopped out. Calling your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together. So you may need to call or contact, or your soulmate may call or contact you this week, because it's all about exploration. It's all about taking an action and contacting each other, talking to each other. But they are ultimately saying you're calling in that person's energy to you. They are becoming closer to you, whether they're there in your life or not. If they are there, your energies are becoming closer, stronger connection, like this ivy growing on the trellis here. Playfulness. So while we have a lot of lighthearted energy swinging, we're having fun here on this swing. So there's things moving, the energy's in motion. When we see a swing going back and forth, it's like things are getting started, they're moving, and it's in a good direction of playfulness. It's not going to be as serious or heavy. It's not going to be as heavy as an energy as maybe as has been in the past for you. And we have finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. So again, it's kind of taking me back to the fish, to the King of Diamonds. So I feel the energy of finances coming up as security, happiness, security coming, exploring and making an effort to contact or come closer to this person in your life is going to be important to change the energy, to move it. And it's also becoming more stable, sort of like the King of Diamonds. So I hope that has helped. I wish I had more time to analyze these, because I feel there's more here from these. But I wanted to keep this video under 15 minutes for uploading, so I want to stop here. But again, you may be getting your own messages, sit and meditate on the cards, listen to what your spiritual team is telling you while you're looking or watching the video. And so yeah, I hope that this reading has helped. And yeah, they're showing me the dog in this card is important as well. So again, it's that loyalty. Dogs are unconditional love. Energy of loyalty coming up here. And I feel that there is an underlying message for one specific person from someone that has passed running through this for the rest of everyone else. There's another message running through it. So I hope that has resonated for everyone. I hope you have a wonderful week ahead. I'm looking forward to the following week, which is Christmas week. I may do a little bit of something extra special for Christmas week. And I'm sending everyone angel blessings and oceans of love.